I hope so. You're okay today? Paul says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel, but it's the power of God unto salvation. Why did Paul say that? He said it because he believed that you could have a relationship with God. That you could have a relationship with God. And he wasn't ashamed of the gospel because the gospel, the good news, is what can help you have a relationship with God. Now, the message of Christianity is the cross. The cross is at the heart of the message. Paul says, we preach Christ crucified. Men seek after wisdom, men seek after knowledge, but we preach Christ crucified. To the Jew, it's a stumbling block. To a Greek, it's foolishness. But Paul said, we preach Christ crucified. When Paul came before the philosophers at Athens, Paul didn't come with clever ideas. He didn't come with clever logic. He didn't come with clever philosophy. He preached God. He preached the judgment. And he preached the cross and the resurrection. And that's our message today. I can boldly say today that if you want to know God, I can boldly say that Jesus Christ died and rose again. And if you want to know God, God commands you today to repent. Repent and find this salvation. This salvation for you. This salvation is there for you. This salvation is offered to you. It is offered freely and lovingly. It is offered tenderly. It is offered openly. It is offered with God's open heart to you today. God offers it openly and lovingly with his arms wide open, saying, I am here. My love is here for you. I want you. I love you. I died for you. And God offers his love to you today. But it's at the cross. We preach Christ crucified. There is the love of God. There is the love of God at the cross. There is the wisdom of God at the cross. There is the knowledge of God at the cross. Men did not work it out. Men did not think it through. Men did not work it out. But God worked it out by the cross. Who would have thought that the answer to your problem is the cross? Who would have thought the answer to the world's problems is the cross? The world looks at it and thinks it's foolish. Religion looks at it, thinks it's foolish. Philosophy looks at it, thinks it's foolish. Science looks at it, thinks it's foolish. But Paul says, we preach Christ crucified. It's not foolish to Paul. Paul said, we preach Christ crucified. Why? Because he, the Lamb of God, shed his blood on that cross for you and for me. And God opens his heart in love to you and me today and says, here is my love. Here, the banquet of love, a wonderful love, a glorious love. My love for you. I died for you. I sacrificed for you. I was broken for you. Here is my love for you. Now will you drink it and take it? Here is my love. I died for you. Will you take my love? And God offers his love to you. Are you going to drink that love? Are you going to drink the love of God in your life? Are you going to say, I understand you died for me. I understand you gave your life for me. I'm going to believe you, Jesus. Forgive me, Jesus. Cleanse me, Jesus.
What do you want to say, bro?
You can say hi.
Hi.
Hi. He gave his life for you. He shed his blood for you on that cross.
God bless you.
He gave his life for you on that cross. That is the love of God for you today. That love is what you need today. That love was given for you. God could not have shown you as much love as he did. We preach Christ crucified. I preach Christ crucified. I preach a crucified Messiah. because the Lord came and died on that cross for you and me. And if you want to go to heaven, you've got to understand that when he died on that cross, he died as a murderer, but he murdered nobody. He died as a thief, but he was no thief. He died for every single person's sin that they did wrong. He died for them, and he died for you. He died for you. That is the love of God at the cross. The love of God for you. The love of God for you. All you got to do is have faith. Faith in him. And believe in him. And trust him as your Lord and Savior. That's what you have to do. Trust him as your Lord and Savior. There is a banquet of the love of God. There is a banquet of the grace of God. God bestows his love to you. He gives his love to you. He pours it out to you. He says, here is my love. I give you my love. Here is all my love for you. And he pours it out on the cross. Shed his blood on the cross. Gave his life on the cross. And all you gotta do is say, I'm coming, Lord, I believe. I'm coming, Lord, I'm a sinner. I'm coming, Lord, I trust you. I'm coming, Lord, I believe in you. You died for me. And I'm coming, and forgive me, and cleanse me, and wash me, and you'll be forgiven. The love of God shed abroad on that cross, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. For God invites you to heaven's glory. He invites you to the heavenly place. He invites you to the heavenlies. He invites you to heaven to sit at the right hand of the Father. He invites you to heaven and all the glories of heaven. He invites you to the eternal kingdom. He invites you to enjoy and feast yourself on eternity and all the glories of eternity. He invites you to feast yourself on the glories to come and the joy to come and the power of heaven and the power of God. He invites you to enjoy him and go to heaven and enjoy the glories of God. You all right, man? To enjoy him. He's offering it to you. Come and drink of all that I have for you in eternity. But it begins at the cross. It begins at the cross. I preach Christ crucified, says Paul. We preach Christ crucified. A crucified Messiah. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes on him shall not perish but have eternal life. That is the glory of God. The glory of God is in the cross. The glory of God is in the cross. The glory of God is in that cross. There, the holiness of God. There, the love of God. There, the wrath of God. The wrath of God and his Son. The love of God, he gave his Son. The holiness of God, he punished his Son. All the character of God is in the cross. Do you want that? Get off that, it's free, yeah? Okay. All the love of God is in the cross. The love of God on the cross. He shed his blood, he gave his blood, he died on that cross and died for you on that cross. And if you want to bring glory to God, if you want to bring honor to God, if you want to know God, you remember that he died on that cross for you. You remember that he died on that cross and shed his blood on that cross and laid down his life for you on that cross. That is the love of God. The love of God for you, offers it to you, gives it to you in all his fullness today, in all his glory today. He offers it to you. He says, here, I am here. I give you my love. I give you my glory. I give it to you. Come, drink in me. I have died for you. I've shed my blood. Come and have faith in me. And he offers you his love today. To drink of his love. Have faith in his love. The love that shed his blood on that cross. I preach Christ crucified. A stumbling block to the Greeks. foolishness to the Greeks, a stumbling block to the Jews, foolishness to the Jews. But I preach Christ crucified, Paul said. Not the wisdom of man, not the wisdom of the world. The wisdom of God. The wisdom of God is in the cross. The power of God is in the cross. The might of God is in the cross. The destruction of the devil is in the cross. There the devil was crushed. There evil was destroyed. The might of God was shown on the cross. The power of God was shown on the cross. And if you want to know God, you got to know that he died on that cross. And there he shed his blood and took the wrath and the punishment that you deserve. And if you want to come home to God, you want to know God, you got to understand he died on that cross. He died on that cross. And the power of God is there. And all evil and all filth was crushed by the mighty Savior, the mighty Lord, who humbled himself and became of no reputation. He became nothing that you could be something. He became a nobody that you could be a somebody. He became punished that you may be set free. He came from heaven, came to earth, lived, mocked, humiliated, died, rose again for you today. For you. The power of God. The power of God for you today. Is here today in Jesus Christ, in the cross of Christ. The power of God is there. All of heaven, all the angels, all the demons, all the galaxies look upon the cross and they gaze in amazement at the wonderful, amazing, mighty love of God. They are amazed at the love of God. They're amazed that God would die for foolish people like you and me. Die for foolishness for you and me. He died for you and me on that cross. He was crushed on that cross and died for you and me. Heaven, glory, majesty, love of God displayed at the cross. Displayed at the cross. Angels look up and are astounded at the cross. That Christ would die for you and me on that cross. That he died for you and me on that cross. Oh, the mighty love of God. That he will come and shed his blood and die on that cross and shed his blood for you and me. Heaven and earth cannot speak of such a wonder, of such a great, wonderful thing. We preach Christ crucified, a stumbling block to the Jews, nonsense to the philosophers of Greeks. But the wisdom of God, the mighty love of God on that cross, scattering through heaven, scattering through the heavenlies, is the love of God on the cross. There he died, and the love shattered the universe with his mighty love, shedding his blood on that cross for you. You could come out of the darkness. Come out of the pain and the darkness. And come out of whatever this world is offering you. Whatever it is offering you is nothing compared to the love of God. As you come out and you come in to God and his love that goes across eternity. Across eternity. Oh, the deep, deep love of Jesus. Vast, unmeasured, boundless, free.
Morning is a mighty ocean in its fullness over me. The cross expands the universe. The love of God expands the universe with his death on that cross. God demonstrates his own love to us. That while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. The glory of God, that God would come down and die. That God would come down and shed his blood. The glory of God, that he would come down and die. And he came down and died for you and for me. If you want to come into that love, if you want to know the love of God, it's not by might, it's not by power, it's not by philosophy, it's not by science, it's not by religion, it's by Christ on the cross. He died to set you free today. He died to set you free. And you can be free today. The love of God. We preach Christ crucified. We preach Christ crucified. That is our message today. The message of God. The message of God today. It is the only way to be saved. The only way to heaven. The only way to know the love of God. The only way to be right with God. The only way is by the cross. He died. He rose again. He conquered death. But on that cross, he took your punishment. He took your wrath. He took your judgment. He died and was punished for you today. And if you want to live in the love of God, if you want to know that there is no condemnation, if you want to know that you are right with God, you've got to understand that he died on that cross. That is the only way to heaven. The only way is at the cross. The only way is at the cross. That is the only way to get saved. The cross of Jesus. The blood of the Lamb was shed for you. Was paid for you. In full. Every debt you owed, every sin that you committed, he paid it with his own blood to you. He paid it with his own blood on that cross. Shed his own blood for you on that cross. Died with his own blood for you on that cross. And if you want to be set free, if you want to be free, if you want to have hope today, you come to the cross. You come to Jesus. The blood of Christ. We preach Christ crucified. Not philosophy, not religion, not science. We preach Christ crucified. And there you can be saved. There you can go to heaven. There you can know God by the cross of Jesus. By the cross of Jesus. The blood was shed for you. The blood was shed for you on that cross. The blood was shed for you. He shed his blood that you may go free today. Say, I don't want to know. I don't care. Say, Jay, I'm not bothered. You're the Bible basher. I don't care. I'm not bothered. But it doesn't change the fact that the blood was shed for you. It doesn't change the fact that the blood was shed for you. The blood was shed for you. The blood was shed for you at the cross. It was shed for you at that cross. And there at the blood you need to go for forgiveness at the blood of Christ. You need that blood to be saved. You need that blood to be cleansed. You need that blood to set you free. That is the blood of Jesus for you. The love of God for you. He died to set you free. We preach Christ crucified. Crucified. He was crucified. He was crucified. He shed his blood. He shed his blood for you. He shed his blood and gave his life. Oh, I can see it now when he died. And as the wrath of God fell upon him, I could see now the angels astonished at his amazing love. And I can see right now the ripples of his love going through eternity as he gave his life for rotten sinners like me and you, that we would love things that are not right, and that we would enjoy things that are not right, that we would enjoy perversion, we would enjoy sexual things that are not right, we will enjoy getting drunk and drugs, we will enjoy evil, and yet he died for us who would enjoy evil. We preach Christ crucified. We preach Christ crucified. Christ died. He died. That is our message today.
God bless you.